role in becoming a police officer. By self-testing yourself once a week on the Fitbit and recording it in your OBP fitness logs, you can show our recruiters a dedication to Captain Fitness. Also, you show that you have what it takes to do the job of a police officer.
So today we're going to go through the components of the fitness pin, which is a mile and a half run or 2.4 kilometers, push-ups, a back extension test, and a sit and reach to test your flexibility.
Exhibitor Council and Fees are going to demonstrate the proper push-up form.
All right, Dorian, if I get you down on the ground. Okay, so for the push-ups, we're going to start with proper hand placement. So Dorian, that's perfect. Your hands are directly underneath your shoulders. And the first thing that he's going to do is make sure that his toes are on the ground and his feet are together for this movement. And what you're going to do is fully extend by pushing up your hands and lower back down until you're just hovering above the ground. Perfect. And keep doing that movement. So with the push-ups, you're going to want to make sure that you're not pausing either at the top or the bottom of the movement. And you're going to continue until you can no longer hold your form or until you voluntarily stop. So until your maximum number of push-ups is reached.
Angie, would you mind demonstrating modified push-ups?
Absolutely. Okay, so for this movement, same thing, you're going to want to place yourself on the ground, hands are directly underneath the shoulders. The difference with this is that your toes, the tops of your feet are planted on the floor, your feet are together, and you're using your knees as the pivot point. So you press up, fully extend, as you can see my knees are still on the ground, lower back down until you're hovering just above the ground. Same movement, not stopping or pausing at the top or the bottom, your feet need to stay on the floor. And this movement also stops when the person can't continue or if they can't hold their form.
The next component is the core endurance test. Before doing this, we have an exercise that we try, which is an arm leg lift to make sure you don't injure yourself. And you'll need to demonstrate that.
All right, so just lay on your stomach. And what you're gonna do is first just lift one leg at a time off the ground. Okay, any pain?
Nope.
All right, next you're going to lift opposite arm and opposite leg off the ground. Any pain? All right, so Dorian's clear to start this test.
All right, Dorian, we're gonna get set up right here. I will hold your legs and put your torso up there, and Angie will walk us through the proper motion.
So first things first, we have the landmark for this activity. So we're looking for the top of Dorian's hip bones, which are right here. I'm gonna make you slide forward. So that right where his hip bones are at the edge of the mat, so perfect.
Okay,
so
right here, your feet.
Got Sergeant Hicks sitting there. Can you just lift off the ground for a second, make sure that's enough weight? Okay, hands back down. Okay, so for this test, what you're going to do is place your arms directly across your shoulders. You're not hanging onto your clothing or anything like that. All right, perfect. So Dorian's head and his back are all nice and in parallel with the ground. And this test continues until he can't hold it anymore or until his form dips. So if his form does dip, we'll give him a warning and let him know that he needs to straighten up. But otherwise, he's going to hold this, and the goal for this test is to hold it for 3 minutes.
The next component is a sit and reach exercise. Get Angie to explain it to Dory.
All right, so this is a test of your flexibility. First, I'm gonna get you to sit on the ground. We're gonna go through just a couple stretches, which is a really good idea to do properly on this test. So we're gonna do the modified burger stretch. I'm gonna get you to get perfect fat leg in, and you're gonna reach out towards your toes. I'm gonna hold this stretch for about 30 seconds, and you're gonna do it for each leg. Okay, so for this test, I'm gonna get you to take your shoes off, because you do this in your soft feet or your bare feet. Perfect. And place your feet on here, just 6 inches apart. Great. And now your legs should be nice and straight. So just slide your hands under your knees. They should just be able to fit. Perfect. Okay, so this movement, what you're going to do is you're going to place your hands directly on top of one another. Okay, so the measurement is actually taken from the hand that's furthest back. So if you go like this, you may think you're further, but we're actually measuring from the furthest hand back. Okay, so I'm going to get you to take a deep breath in. And as you exhale, you're going to slide your hands down the ruler. Perfect. Good, you're gonna hold it for a couple seconds. Awesome. 41, pretty flexible. So the next component is the mile and a half or 2.4 kilometer run, which is performed outdoors at the Provincial Police Academy during the first week. Practicing for this component of the test should involve a once weekly attempt at the 2.4 kilometer run to see what your score is and see if you need to make any improvements. So you always wanna remember to give your body a warm up and a cool down as part of good training practice. And you wanna run this test in the fastest time that you possibly can. So it's really important to track your progress on your fitness log so that you can see where you need to make improvements, or you can make a goal of shedding a few seconds off your time each week.
Now that we've covered all the components of the OBP Fit Test, make sure to self-test once a week and to record it in your logs.
Check out our contact information on the screen and reach out if you have any questions or need clarification.